I'm gonna ask you the same question, but then you say it as if you hadn't been in the rap game. Just imagine that you weren't, and then answer the question. Hey, so Steven, you still eat cereal?
Absolutely not. It is actually exponentially high in sugar and carbs, and it is not for someone like me.
That is awesome. Yo,
we're here.
Let's do it. Yeah, I don't want to do those questions quick fire. Let's just answer the question.
Come on, man. Some of these are like rapid fire style.
Okay, whatever you want to do. So, this episode, what are we calling this one, man? What are they gonna learn? We don't know what you're gonna learn because we're actually answering your questions.
Yes.
It's funny how life works
when you answer questions.
You might be asking yourself, because the podcast is called Funny How Life Works, where we use funny to help you understand how life works, and we're actually going to be taking questions from you about how life works. So you may be asking yourself, how can I learn about life by asking questions? Well, first of all, if you're asking that question, that's you just twisted up. But either way, you're about to find out.
Okay.
I love this podcast.
You'll be laughing out loud, and all of a sudden, boom, something that can really help you drops in your lap.
I like it because I unexpectedly learn about life.
It is so funny.
I get to laugh and learn about life at the same time.
I like listening to Funny How Life Works with the car of my parents. With the car in my parents.
So, what we've done is we've taken random questions from Facebook.
I must introduce myself.
Oh, wow. Okay. Well, I was just about to do that.
I refuse to move forward.
Two steps forward? Let me introduce you.
I need to say my name.
Tech guy Nick.
Wow.
Couldn't be here. Because he got another job.
Me amo Kyle Ray.
Me amo
su hermano.
But Kyle is here with us, everybody, from Scent
hey,
Church.
Hey, what's up?
Great friend of mine, kind of a pastor.
Kind of.
I mean, you're a friend and a pastor.
Yeah.
Hey, so you're about to do a doggone Iron Man, dude.
Yeah.
That tone sounds like you may be reconsidering this thing.
Do you remember a few episodes ago where we interviewed that guy?
Alex Weber. Yes.
Fail proof.
Did you read the book?
I didn't read it yet.
Okay.
But I've been showing up, right?
Well, so I don't know if you're fail-proof then, buddy.
No, remember his main lesson was...
Show up, buddy.
Just show up. I'm trying to celebrate just showing up.
That was episode 133.
Because I'm going to tell you something, man.
I think.
There is no evidence as of today that I will be able to swim 2.4 miles in 7 months from now.
Wow. Can you swim? Let's start there.
I can. But the thing that needs to click hasn't clicked yet.
Oh.
This breathing thing. I don't know about you.
It's important. It's very important.
It is important. But when you swim, you're supposed to start breathing out immediately when you put your face in the water. That's counterintuitive. My childhood said when you put that face underwater, you hold your breath.
You hold your breath.
No, it don't work that way with swimming.
Right.
And if you hold your breath, you're going to be out of breath. You get too much carbon dioxide in your lungs and you're out of breath. So I'm at the pool watching people, old 70-year-old people, just lap after lap after lap, and I do one and I'm just
hey, so maybe try this, check it out. What if you instead of swimming hear me out for real, what if next time you go to the pool, what if you just practice exhaling underwater?
Yeah, that's what I'm supposed to do. It's just
have
that
you done
feel,
it no I, no I'm not I I'm haven't. Not talking about why you're swimming, I mean standing there.
I know. Uh-huh. That's an exercise they say you should do. It's just when you go to the pool and you're in the lap lane, which is the place I go. It's not like the kiddie pool. It's laps. You feel a little guilty if you're not swimming laps.
Who feels guilty?
Me. It's a limiting belief in my mind.
Yeah, absolutely.
I can't start my workout just putting my face on the water, blowing out.
Go to the kiddie pool and do it.
I will.
That's what you do. Go to the kiddie pool. Because right now you probably got a muscle memory to saying, yo,
Absolutely.
You hold your breath here. You black. You don't be breathing underwater. Who you think you are?
There are a lot of limiting beliefs wrestling with.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
But the fact that you know it means it's going to click. You just got to keep doing it.
Yeah.
At the risk of sounding like a doula, breathe, bro. Breathe.
You know, my dad, we grew up in Detroit. My dad used to swim across from Detroit to Canada, across the Detroit River.
Oh, yeah. I remember that was before he was a police officer. He was running from the police.
So one swimming workout I went to, I just told myself, it's got to be in me somewhere. It's got to be in there somewhere.
It is.
So it's going to click.
Yeah, and I would almost look at it like instead of saying it's got to be Yeah, yeah. That's a good way to look at it. It is in you.
It's in me.
Now you just got to bring it out.
Yep.
That's great, dude.
Yeah, so.
That's great.
That's the story of my life.
I believe you could swim.
Hey, I'll take that. You should record
Hold
that.
Hold your breath and blow it out.
I got some questions for you. Blow we it start
out.
The episode.
Blow it out.
Well, did we already start the episode?
Non-sponsor.
Ah, yeah. Non-sponsor sponsor.
Is none other than.
Minnie's Food Pantry.
Nope. Oh, you know, I'm supposed to go to Minnie's Food Pantry.
See, but you don't even want them to be the non-sponsor.
I do.
Sponsor.
I do like Minnie Foods, but their vision is limited.
When are you going?
They need to be the Maximum Food Pantry.
Why not Mickey's? You ever think about it that way? Somebody, not Minnie Mouse, but
so
Mickey's.
Somebody could slip it to them. Slip me a Mickey.
Wow.
What does that mean? You used to drink and stuff. What does that mean?
I didn't drink like that. I mean,
what
like
does it mean when somebody slips somebody a Mickey?
It means that they. Put something in somebody's drink that's gonna knock them out. It's the like, it's the old like date rape.
So do you remember
type
the last
approach.
Time you slipped a Mickey to somebody?
I never did that.
yeah, pass.
I remember one time we made some jungle juice in college. We had a party. We had these big McDonald's style coolers. Actually, we said we'll supply the jungle. You bring the juice.
That is so bad. Wow. You had not received your call yet, had
not
you?
Not yet. It was a pre-Petra day.
So our non-sponsor sponsor is Minnie's Food Pantry.
Yeah, they provide food to
really?
Families
wow.
in need.
What do you know? It's bananas.
But they also need volunteers to come there and help pack and sort food. You know, a lot of places like that, volunteerism declined when the pandemic started because people were concerned about catching COVID.
Hey, we should go down there and invite our listeners.
Yeah, I'm going down there in February.
February 19th, right?
Yes.
Yes. I think I'll be there too. I'm not 100%. Scent Serving Day. We're going to go, and if you're listening, and if you're, you know, I don't care where you are, you could be in Mabumbu or Zambia.
As long as they fill out the form.
Fly in. Oh,
there is a volunteer form. And Minnie's website.
Go to Minnie's website, fill out the volunteer form, and we'll see you there February 19th.
Yep.
Like we'll be there.
Yeah, in the morning.
In the morning, packing up food. Let's go ahead and pack up all the food we possibly can.
Yeah.
For Mimi's.
So Minnie's.
For Minnie.
Minnie's Food Pantry.
Minnie's Food Pantry. We're going to be there February 19th, so I hope you're there too. It could be a really cool, funny how life works when you help people episode.
Hey, what size shoe do you wear?
12, 13.
You know, at the time we're recording this, it's a cold spell coming through.
A lot of people are concerned about it. We from Michigan. We're like, what? I'm about to go play tennis.
I heard that some of the emergency homeless shelters, like warming stations, are asking for like donations of men's shoes, like between 9 and 13. So if you got some extra shoes sitting around the house.
Between 9 and 13 p.m. or 8?
No, size.
I do have some shoes.
Mm-hmm. I'll tell you the name of the nonprofit.
Tell me now.
Salvation Army. Their warming center in Plano.
No, I don't trust them people.
See.
No, I love Salvation Army. We're actually going to be doing some events for them. Hey, man, let's start the show. I'll do it. I'll donate some shoes, for real.
Right.
Are you going to take them there, though? Because I can't be donating shoes and my time. Like, I can't do both. Like, how are they going to get there?
If you pack them up this evening, because tomorrow is supposed to be a sheet of ice.
If the shoe fit. No, I'd love to do that. Salvation Army, take them some of my shoes. I got some extra shoes that I don't wear.
All right.
They want both feet, though? They want
Dude, yeah, they do.
Find the Apple scoop behind you. So, yo, let's take some voicemails.
Well, actually, can I just ask you some of these questions that came in first?
From Facebook?
From somewhere.
So these questions are your questions from Facebook.
And these are rapid fire. I'm going to say the
no,
name.
No, man.
Okay. Well,
rapid fire. It depends on the answer, though.
Okay,
but
I'll
go ahead.
Tell you
ask
your
question.
This is from Joseph Thedford.
On Facebook.
Michael
Joseph
Jr.
Thedford?
Yes, Michael
like
Jr.
Thedford.
Thedford. Like, wow. Remember Sanford and Son? Thedford and Sons. Michael Jr., I was wondering, do you say soda or pop?
Soda pop.
See, you're making it difficult. We know we're from the Midwest. We say pop.
Well, I used to say pop till I moved to New York. Now I start saying soda.
Okay. Michael Jr.
Now I don't drink any of it because my wife is like, we ain't doing that. Get you some water.
All right. So this is Tracy Edwards. This is not rapid fire. Michael Jr., I was wondering, did Jesus grow up in a quote-unquote stable family? You get it? That Tracy tried to bring the funny?
I'm not going to comment. Thank you, Tracy. Thank you so
much. Yes. So here it is. Michael Jr., I was wondering, this is from Mark Armando.
What up, Mark Armando? Mark Armando.
Why do they call the cereal grape nuts if they don't contain grapes or nuts?
You know, that was the worst cereal growing up. My dad used to have, did your dad have grape nuts
you
too?
You actually bought it?
No, my dad used to.
My dad was a Raisin Bran.
Dude, my dad would have grape nuts. And the first time we were out of regular cereal, my dad was like, get some of grape nuts. And I pour some milk in there. And all I can recall is the top of my mouth. It was gravel. Like it, that stuff. And the milk had no, it had no effect on the grape nuts. Have you ever had grape nuts?
No. I've had Captain Crunch. That's roof cutting cereal, dude, right there.
Captain Crunch is nothing.
Cut them roof doggone your mouth.
No, grape nuts? That stuff stays gravelly the whole doggone time. My dad, grape nuts and shredded wheat. That's what my dad put all shredded. Not the shredded wheat where you flip it and it's white people once. I mean, you know, it's candy on the other side. It was just straight shredded doggone wheats.
Hey, this one, I want you to tell me before you answer it.
My mom will make us malt meal.
How many times you think you've been asked this question?
I really like malt meal a lot. Let me see if I can ask the question.
Michelle Garland. Michael Jr., I was wondering, does your wife have the same sense of humor as you do? How many times have you been asked that question?
Normally they ask about my kids. My wife does not have the same sense. She's brilliant and really smart, but we're different. Like, that's why God kind of put us together so we could. So, yeah, not the same sense of humor.
No, all right. All right.
We both just.
I have a question from one of your top fans, Linda.
Sometimes my dad would make grits.
I liked what grits. You didn't like grits?
I didn't understand it. Like, why is it white? I thought it was chopped up rice or something. It just didn't make sense to
me. You think Ari will pick up my sweater that I threw over there on the floor? She was going to walk past it. Then she remembered we were on video, but she's not.
She's like, let me act like I care for people. Go ahead.
This is from a top fan of yours, Linda Leach Byer.
What up, Linda Leach Byer? You be buying leeches?
Michael Jr., what is the parenting technique you swore you would never do before having kids that you now do?
Oh, yeah. I said I would never discipline my kids by giving them grape nuts. And and we gave them some grape nuts. Yeah. Yeah. I don't think I ever swore that I wouldn't do anything. My parents, I wasn't conscious enough to know what my parents did, what I thought they did wrong or right. And now looking at it, I'm like, yo, my parents is dope.
I'm going to do two more questions, and I noticed.
Two more questions. We're going to take some voicemails after that.
Mary Beth Buchel says.
Mary Beth Buchel from Facebook.
She says.
Or maybe it's Instagram. We're Michael JR Comedy on all platforms. If you want to leave your comment, we might actually answer it like we're doing right now.
You have to say the first thing that comes to your mind. Me? I was wondering.
Wait, right now?
When I finish the question.
Chicken. That is hilarious. Hey, if you missed that episode, what episode was that? It's like four episodes ago. We're listening to the Bible experience, the black version of the Bible being read, and the dude says,
chicken.
He said,
he's
elephant,
donkey.
Yeah, donkey,
horse,
chicken.
You ain't right. You ain't right, man.
Hey, chicken is good, though.
So, Mary Beth says, I was wondering, what do you enjoy doing more? Stand up,
comedy? My grandmother would give us Raisin
Bran. Or acting.
That was always a treat when we have Raisin Bran.
Which
one? At my grandmother's house, but we add sugar to it. My uncle.
Think about a seesaw on the plate.
Hold on. My uncle used to take cereal because my uncle was kind of swollen. And he was around my age, a little older. I tell you this before.
Mm-mm.
My uncle, dude, one time I go in there, he making Frosted Flakes. He put it in a mixing bowl.
Yeah.
My uncle was swole, right? He was big. He put in a mixing bowl, like it would hold almost a whole box of Frosted Flakes. He would put it in a mixing bowl, then he would crush it down, and then pour some more and crush it, for real. Then pour milk in there and just eat out the mixing bowl.
And I know that cereal got soggy.
I don't think it had
maybe
time.
Maybe not.
One time my uncle, like he had a girlfriend who was, she was really, they both like to eat. Let me just say that. They both like to eat a lot. And but she was really shy. She might be listening right now. I ain't going to say her name. She was really shy. And me and my boy Cal Wayne, my grandmother lived on Adam Street.
Yeah.
And I would always go visit my grandmother. I'm a grown man. I would do stuff people thought was weird, like wear my seatbelt. Like, and I'm 19 years old. I'm wearing a seatbelt. Like, take this seatbelt off. You got a nice car. I'm like, take it off. Because people thought that it was cool just to roll like this as opposed to. Anyway. So we go over there, and my uncle, who is only like 4 or 5 years older than me, so we were like kind of the same.
Yeah.
His girlfriend is there, and she's super shy. And he just made her this big bacon hamburger sandwich. And we walk in as he puts it in front of her. And we're sitting there kicking at the table, talking. We don't got no food. And she not eating her food. Like, she won't eat in front of us. And I could tell it was a little weird, but that sandwich looked amazing. And I know she wanted to eat it, dude. So we was like, hey, man. I said, all right, grandma, see you later. She always offered us some bananas. Some, want some fruit? Right? We'd always get some fruit. Yeah. So we leave, right? We go get in the car and leave. And I'm like, snap, I forgot my keys.
No.
I come back. The sandwich is gone. Like, it's gone. My boy Calvin was like, dude, her fingertips is bleeding. Did you do this? Oh, my goodness.
You answered the question.
No, no, no. What was the question? I didn't, what was
which
the reading?
Do you
again?
Like more, stand-up comedy or acting? Stand-up comedy.
That's oh, thing, I would man. Say, yeah, because I'm not really an actor, so to say. I'm just being me. And all of the movies I've been in, Selfie Dad, and whatever other movies I've been in, War Room and some other stuff, then I'm really just being me. So I like being me more so than acting like somebody else.
Have you ever heard that song, Serial, by Stephen Malcolm?
You just asked me about music? he just asked me about music, everybody.
You all should Google Serial by Stephen Malcolm and play a part of it, because you love the song.
Really? Oh, pull up Serial. Can y'all pull up Serial by
Stephen Malcolm?
By
Stephen Malcolm.
Malcolm Serial. Jamal Warner.
Malcolm Jamal Warner.
Serial. Malcolm X. Serial.
You know what? Stephen Malcolm might be.
We're
the
about to listen to it right now.
Most successful hip hop artist to come out of Grand Rapids, Michigan. Now listen to these lyrics, man.
Hey, I don't know if this is gonna make YouTube cut though.
Yeah.
Oh, they might.
Yeah.
They might flag it.
Yeah.
He might grow up on the same street.
Wait. Stop. Let's do this. In case this can't play on YouTube, let's go ahead and pull up the lyrics. Because the lyrics is pretty much what you're talking about, right?
Yeah.
He's from Grand Rapids?
He is.
He looked like a DeBarge.
We should call him.
You want to call him?
Yeah, why not? You want to?
Okay, yeah.
Am I still talking to Bluetooth?
Wait, let's get the lyrics first.
Okay.
Let's get the lyrics. Mm-hmm. And you set up his Bluetooth.
All right.
And let me read the lyrics. I need some Fruit Loops.
Yes.
Grab me some Lucky Charms. Never gonna have to match.
Too much.
Cinnamon Toast Crunch. I'm talking about 2% milk. For these tricks I'm about to kill?
He's talking about cereal.
About to kill some tricks.
remember that trick cereal?
The yeah, rabbit? I do remember tricks. But we didn't have tricks.
Tricks are for kids.
Well, we couldn't afford tricks. We had pranks. pranks. We're going to call the rapper. Yeah, what's his name?
Stephen Malcolm.
Oh, good old Stephen Malcolm. Yeah. That's his real name? He don't got a rapper name?
No, he don't have a rapper name.
Wow, he went with his real name.
See, people answers the up. Phone. Nobody answers for me. Well, my mama did that one episode.
Is it Bluetooth? You?
Hey, Steve.
My guy, how you doing?
Good, man. How you doing?
Doing good, man. Just on the road.
I was just telling somebody. First of all, I'm on a podcast with Michael Jr., who was born and raised in Grand Rapids.
This is his conscious talking.
Whatever, man. And I was telling about your song, Serial.
I just want you to know, man. I appreciate what you're doing, but
turn up, man.
Hey, man.
What's up, man?
We were looking at the lyrics of Serial.
Yeah, so I got a podcast called. We do a podcast together called Funny How Life Works, and we randomly pulled up your lyrics, and now I'm sitting here, and we just called you randomly, dude. So you're on a podcast promoting what you're doing. We're looking at the lyrics.
Scroll up on the lyrics.
Scroll up. Start at the beginning. Let's read some of the lyrics. I'm gonna stop when I need to. Go ahead, read.
I need some Fruit Loops.
Uh huh.
Grab me some Lucky Charms.
Grab me some Lucky Charms.
Never have too much.
Now let me ask you something real quick, Steve. Did you have a munchies when you wrote this song? Like, what was going through your dome when you was, like, was it early in the morning? Like, how'd you come up with these?
Hold on. I like the one. Oh. Nah, man. Nah, absolutely not, bruh. It was actually a writing exercise, man.
Uh-huh.
So basically for writers to break using the same verbiage, what you do is you pick a certain topic and you just write about that. So you'll zone in on something, you know what I mean? So yeah, bro, it was a writing exercise, and I legitly do love cereal.
Oh,
he's a serial killer.
So you, yeah.
Hold on 1 second.
We're live. We're not going to hold
on. Scroll down some more of the lyrics. Past the chorus there. Keep going. So it says, don't care what the size it is. Wake up early. Wake up every morning. You know what time it is. Don't pour a cup of that Folgers.
He on the phone. Let's have him do it.
Steven, you there?
Are you doing your own beat right now, bro?
Okay. Steven,
let me hear the lyrics. You say the lyrics.
We lost him.
He hung up on us, man.
He hung up on us. We lost
him. Dude, he hung up on us, man.
Didn't we call
him? Don't call him back, man. Listen, I'm about to call Trip Lee, man. I ain't calling.
I'm gonna hook you up on Bluetooth.
I'm gonna call.
You gonna have Trip Lee do Steven's lyrics?
Yeah, why not, man?
All right, here we go.
So I got Trip Lee. Let's No, we can go Steven. Let's get Steven
back.
You
hear that siren?
That's your boy. That's your boy Steven. They got him, man.
They didn't get him.
Steven Malcolm.
He's on tour.
He on tour right now?
Yo.
Yeah.
My bad.
That's all right, man.
Yeah. Hey, get an iPhone. Versus, I know you're on Android and it's good for traveling or whatever, but we need to get an iPhone.
Are you on tour right now?
Yeah, man.
Where are you?
I think we're somewhere almost hitting Louisville, I think.
Hey, Steven, let me ask you, have you noticed that you started getting like a rapper tone when you started rapping? Like you talk a little slower, like in real life, you're like, yo, man, yeah, we're just kind of chilling, man. Like you didn't talk like that when you was in grade school, right? Did you notice that change take place?
Absolutely, man. You know what I'm saying? A little bit. Slowly.
That is awesome.
But surely, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You rest the, you know what I'm saying, the mouth and the face as much as possible.
Yeah.
And turn up on the stage.
Yeah.
So, Steven.
Yeah, hold on. Let me park here for a second.
Because
when you do that, like, it changes if, like, whenever somebody's career don't work out, it changes and goes back to interview styles. Like, yeah, man, sir, yeah, I'll be here on time. I can do whatever you need me to do. I'm a good worker. It changes back. But I'm looking at your lyrics, and even your beat was pretty dope, dude. Like, there's some good stuff there.
Yeah.
What were you going to say?
Yeah, no,
I was going to say, Steven, Mike, what elementary school did you go to in Grand Rapids? Or did you do elementary school?
No, I did elementary school in Florida, actually.
When did you get to Grand Rapids? What grade?
Six.
So what middle school did you go to there?
Crestwood.
Oh, Kentwood. You were out in Kentwood and Crestwood. All right.
Yeah, man.
So Michael Jr. grew up in Grand Rapids. And
I did grow up in Grand Rapids. That's true.
And I remember you and I were talking one day about being a big fish in a small pond, small fish in a big pond, L.A. versus Grand Rapids, that type of thing. You were talking about YouTube views, right? Like, if you couldn't get a million YouTube views or something like that. Where are you at on all that now, career-wise, like, in terms of where you wanted to be, views and all of that content?
Hey, but when you answer the question, I need you to freestyle the answer, though. Can you freestyle the answer?
Absolutely, yeah.
Oh, here we go.
All my answers is freestyling. Yeah, man,
I meant rhyme the answer.
Oh, rhyming it?
Yeah. That might
be a little tough.
Hold on.
Wait, he broke out. He's breaking up. Okay, so
Kyle, I got nothing.
Kyle,
I need you
to freestyle his how y'all met.
How we met.
How y'all met.
All right, here we go. I remember the day back in the studio. We were at the edge, and I said, hey, man, yo, I think you a rapper. I think I do it, too. If you just let me come and hang out with your crew, I can get some YouTube hits if you just play my song. I let my lyrics flow, and you can sing along. Join me on my verse. You'll make it. I won't, but that's okay because people just don't understand that I'm a pastor, not a rapper.
Yo, that was dope. You was killing it.
Oh,
wow. Stay behind the pool, bro. Yeah.
That's actually how we first met.
For real?
Seriously. They were down at the studio and they said, Pastor Kyle, you used to like rap in high school, didn't you? I was like, man, it's basement taste.
Back in
stuff.
The 20s.
They said, You wanna just rap a taste? I went in there and they started playing this beat and I just flowed. Next thing you know, Steven added a verse. Beacon Light added a verse.
Wow.
They produced a song. And then as soon as he made it famous, he deleted my song from YouTube.
Hold on. It's deleted?
I can't find that song, man. Your team, your producer said no. Nope.
I think some of the members of your church deleted that thing. It's like, man, we can't have this out here.
That was famous, man.
Dang. Infamous. I didn't even know.
Yeah.
I don't know where it's at.
Yeah.
So go back to the song Serial for a minute. Just real quick before we let you go. Don't care what the size it is. Wake up every morning. You know what time it is. Don't pour a cup of that Folgers. Pour me the marshmallow clovers. When it comes size of the bowl, the bigger the better.
Here's the thing. He got brand name cereal, dude. You grew up pretty well. You like, are you from the suburbs of Grand Rapids?
Yeah.
Because all your cereal
is
Kentwood.
Listen,
Kentwood. Yeah. That
was I just love the best of the best there is, man.
That's dope, man.
You still eat cereal?
Man, I slowed down, you know what I mean? I like staying in shape, you know what I mean? I've realized it's nothing but carbs and sugar, so I slowed down on it.
Can you see, just real quick, can you answer this next question? But kind of answer as if you, like you needed a job. Like, I just want to see if there's a different tone to the answer. So I'm going to ask you the same question, but then you say it as if you hadn't been in the rap game. Just imagine that you weren't, and then answer the question. Hey, so, Steven, you still eat cereal?
Absolutely not. It is actually exponentially high in sugar and carbs, and it is not for someone like me.
That is awesome. That is dope. Well, you're awesome, man. Thanks for picking up the call, man. We just randomly thought we'd reach out to you, man. Hey, how can people find out about your music?
Man, just go to StephenMalcolm.com, man. If you're in the Florida area, we on tour right now. If you're in Nashville, we hit Nashville, Chicago, and Grand Rapids, man. So check me out. Get tickets now. We on road.
All right. I like it, man. Good stuff, bro.
Appreciate you. Can people still Cash App you some funds for your tour?
Absolutely, man. Yes, sir. Cash App me if you want to, man. IMG Malcolm. That's IMG Malcolm. Let's get it.
Wow. All right, cool. Man, he put that rapper boys back home. All right,
bro.
Hey, we got some white listeners too, man. Say the same thing in another. No, I'm just playing. Good stuff, man. We're going to have people reach out to you, man. You're awesome. Thanks for picking up.
Later.
Bless up, my G. Yama.
Yeah, right. Cool. He calls you my G.
He's talking to you.
He thinks you're God?
Nah, he's talking about my grandpa. Cool.
Hey, let's take a voicemail before we bounce. I do want to do at least one voicemail.
Oh, yeah.
That was cool, man. I don't even have rapper friends.
I didn't know you had rapper friends either.
I do got rapper friends. Yeah, Triple E is dope, man.
Yeah, he is.
I didn't know who he was, so I heard his music, and then I realized, oh, snap, this is my boy. For real, I didn't even know. All right, we're going to take a voicemail. Let's take a voicemail.
This is going to be good.
We'll see.
My name is Leah. Michael Jr., I was wondering, what does dope mean? I was born in 49. Dope was not a good thing. So it seems like you're using that word as something that's good. Would you explain that to me, please?
Don't you love the curiosity?
See, that is amazing, dude. We just had Steven on there, and I just explained to him that some people might not know some stuff, and then suddenly we get this voicemail. Man. Just so you know, we don't listen to voicemails beforehand. We just play them.
That was nice.
Wow. That was right on point.
Oh, man, she's heard you say that's dope.
Yeah, because she don't know what it means.
A couple episodes ago, we talked about how dope has made a comeback.
Yeah, dope made a comeback, but she don't know what it is.
And she's curious. That's the best part.
Oh, that is,
she was not judgmental.
Absolutely.
She's like, I'm sensing that you're using it in a positive
light.
A positive light.
I, too, would like to enjoy the usage of the word dope.
Because when I was a child, it was not a good thing.
It wasn't good. We had to stay away from it, even.
Do you remember what dope used to mean?
Yeah, dope was like...
Well, not the drugs. I'm talking about in her era.
In her era.
It's like a dumb person. Like,
oh, you yeah, dope. In her era. You dope.
Yeah. But wow. Now if you say God is dope, imagine how that sounds.
Yeah. Wow. I never thought about that. So to answer your question, what's her name again? I can't see it on the screen.
Leah.
Leah, to answer your question, dope is a word of endearment to whatever the subject is. So if I said Pastor Kyle is... Never mind, that doesn't feel right.
Wow.
If I said that these shoes that Pastor Kyle has on, they're dope, that means I actually like them. So dope, when it turned into a drug term, was actually referring to dopamine, which is what the brain releases whenever it's having fun or it's enjoying things. So now we've just converted that to an object or to a person or to a situation and say, yo, that is dope. That kind of gives me a rush. I feel really good. It makes me happy to see such a thing. Wow. So when we say dope, that's actually what we're referring to. Wow, great question. Thank you so much for calling. Hey, everybody, don't forget, if you want to leave a voicemail, we're going to listen to another one. They just dial this number. You want to tell them what the number is, Kyle?
Yeah, 903-213-2019.
Yeah, you just dial, hit that number, and I like to slouch some time in the couch because anyway,
I want to say it like Stephen Malcolm would say it. Yo.
Yeah.
Yo,
so,
G,
yo, look, let me set you up. Yo, dog. Why don't you go ahead and let them know what them digits is that they need to push on in order to do the thing,
yo,
dog.
My G, it's like 903.
Yeah,
921 Trey. 213-2019. Drop us a line. It'll be just fine. You might get mine. Yeah.
Yo. We'll take one more voicemail, then we're going to go off the cuff.
Mm-hmm. Hi, this is Elena from Virginia. And Michael Jr., I was wondering, how do you come up with the topics for your podcast episodes? And I just wanted to say, I love your podcast. I didn't even know you had a podcast, so I've listened to all the episodes. this summer. And my favorite are when Dory and Mike Goodwin are on, because I think you guys are an amazing comedic trio. So I just wanted to share that. And God bless you. Thank you for your ministry and making us all smile. Bye.
She didn't listen to all the episodes.
That is awesome. Well, this voicemail probably came in a while. We don't do voicemails that often, so don't feel bad, Kyle. When did this voicemail come in?
I did an episode with Dory.
25th last year.
That's when I started.
Yeah, it came in last year. So it was before you. Yeah. She didn't even know you existed.
That's true.
Kind of like your birth mom.
Wow.
That's not true.
That really
your
hurt.
Mom, your mom didn't. No,
I was stung, man. But I'm going to press in and ask myself, why is that joke bothering me?
Well done. Well done.
Hey, so, yeah, she wants to know how you come up with the topics, these poignant topics for this podcast. Like, I mean, like that one, man, funny how life works when you take a kid into your home, or funny how life works when you, you know, minister to a homeless person.
So our goal is to, we really want to teach people how life works. And we're not saying that we understand everything about life. I mean, we press into the Bible. Pastor Kyle's a great Bible teacher. And I just really started my career out wanting just to make people laugh. But that was only dealing with a symptom that I really feel like I'm called to on a deeper level. So if there's anything we can do to help people understand life better in any way, we want to bring that to people in a way that is more palatable. So we wrap it around and funny. So if someone is out there and we believe they have a story or a career that could help other people, we just want to present it in a way that is funny and can help them understand how life works.
And it's fair to say, you say you find funny everywhere.
That's true. I do.
So... really, you can find funny in just about anybody's story. So really, Elena, the titles are made up on the spot.
No, we do months of research.
You do on the people and the stories.
Yes, but the titles.
Yeah, the titles.
Yeah, the titles.
Sometimes
funny how life
the titles emerge in the context of finding the funny in someone's story.
Absolutely.
So I think Elena, it'd be good for her to know there's a certain planning that happens, but then there's a certain spontaneity that goes with it. And I think that's the beauty of, you know, it's how funny how life works.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. That's dope. So I'll go off the cuff. And if you want to do one as well, no, I'll just do it.
No, you do it this time.
That's fine. The off the cuff moment, I'm going to go off the cuff on, is when we randomly talk to your rapper friend, Stephen Malcolm. Mm-hmm. So if you notice, we picked up on the fact that Stephen Malcolm kind of started, that he probably always didn't speak the way he's speaking. And as a rapper, his tone kind of changed. He mentioned that he was conserving his energy for when he's on the stage. He wanted to kind of relax his muscles or whatnot. So some of it is on purpose, but some of it is just intuitive because of the atmosphere, because of the people that he's around. Have you took inventory of the people that you are around? Because if you haven't, believe me when I tell you that you are being influenced. The things that you are currently doing, the experiences that you're having in life are a direct impact of those people you have around you. So be very sensitive to who you have around you, and even try to be a better person for the people that you are around. This changes things significantly. It'll change the way you talk. It'll change what you notice. It'll change what you bring in and what you give out. So be purposeful about what you put in, so you can be even more purposeful in line with what God has you to put out. It's funny how life works. Boom.
That's great, man. You know, one time I was talking to Stephen Malcolm.
Really?
Yeah, I was talking to him about, I said, this challenge of you make hip hop music. Some people would say, If I'm a Christian and God knows that, why do I have to talk about Christ in my rap?
Yeah.
Right? I should be able to talk about whatever I want, including if I use profanity. It shouldn't matter as long as God knows my heart.
Yeah, that's what they always say.
But Stephen Malcolm, I loved how he responded. He's like, I can't not talk about Christ. Changed my life. Like, I don't, if I'm going to rap out of a place of realness and what happened in my life, I can't avoid talking about
Jesus.
And so I remember it was so powerful because same age, I was talking to another guy the same age that had gone out to L.A., tried to pursue a rap career, had grown up in the church, but didn't want to talk about Jesus in his raps, and it was failing miserably. He was just running all sorts of hardship, and he was homeless out in L.A., and I put the two of them together, and I was hoping that Stephen could convey to him, like, look, man, you can't avoid Christ. And,
right.
But the other guy, he just wanted to figure out how to do it his own way, and it just has not worked out.
from the abundance of the heart, the mouth will speak.
Mm-hmm.
Like whatever you put in your heart is going to show up in your walk.
Yeah. Wow. I'm gonna go ahead and cash app him some dollars for his tour right now. He's doing an ambitious thing as a young man coming out of Grand Rapids. This is his first self-funded tour. He's done a record company deal and all of that.
Hey, send him some money for me too, man.
I will, man.
Send him like, I don't know. What were you going to give him? How much?
I was going to give him $200.
Oh.
it's a longer story.
Well, just, that. You sent him, you're going to send him 200. Just send him 100 and then send another 100 for me.
do you even have Cash App downloaded on your phone?
I actually don't, man. Yeah. I don't know how to Cash App anybody.
Yeah.
Hey, but you know, speaking of which, if you want to give to Funny for the Forgotten, you can Cash App Funny for the Forgotten. I don't really know how that works, but give it a shot. We're on PayPal too.
I'm going to add a note from Michael and Kyle.
Oh, that's dope.
And Petra.
That's dope.
Yeah, there you go.
Dope. Yo, this thing is done. We did it. Awesome.
Later.